Okay, good morning everybody. This is gonna be a vlog, a Christmas vlog. It is the 24th of December, meaning Christmas Eve, and that's when usually me and my family celebrate Christmas back at home. But I'm not back at home, I'm in Greece. And this year, it's a bit different. I'm gonna be celebrating Christmas by myself. It's gonna be interesting, but I have some things planned out for myself, so it's gonna be fine. And I will just take you guys with me on my day. And first things first, we're gonna wash our face, because my face, like my skin here, it has gotten bad. And I know, like, if you look right, I mean, the quality is, my phone's quality is so bad you can't tell that I have a bad like skin. But like, I used to have such clear skin, like no, like I had a clear skin. And ever since I got here, I have like on like the cheeks here and also on my forehead some visitors every now and then, so it's annoying. So first things first, we gotta wash my face, and yeah, let's go to the bathroom and I will see you there. Okay, and we have made it to the bathroom. I look rough, but I don't know, you can kind of tell, but my eyes, they are a bit swollen because yesterday I decided to cry for like 5 minutes. And now when I think about it, I haven't cried in a while, so it was a long time coming. It's good to cry every now and then because, I don't know, we are washing my face right now. And what one of my friends told me, I think it was Sara, I think she told me, to like when you wash your face, to first wash it with warm water and then rinse with cold water. It somehow helps with the skin. So, and because I need help with my skin, I'm gonna have to do that. So you have to pat your face dry, because if you drag like this, then it's bad for your skin, you're gonna get wrinkles. So yeah, that's the face routine. Hey, that's the skin routine. Okay, so I just saw my breakfast, oatmeal with apples, with cinnamon and cinnamon and apples. And yeah, that's my breakfast usually. I don't know if you're watching this video in the morning, I hope you're having breakfast with me, or if you're watching it in the evenings, dinner, whatever. But there is something I want to discuss here. I'll talk about, open up, it's random. But if you're one of those people who sleeps with their socks on, like, you know, at night, I mean, that's when you sleep, I have a life hack for you. Or it's something that has been working for me for, why is it so crooked? Is it straight now? A few years ago, I used to sleep with two socks on. And then I started to notice that every morning when I woke up, one of the socks was gone. And it was always like on my right foot. At some point, I didn't even bother putting on the sock anymore on my right foot, because I would take it off in my sleep anyways. So now here as well, like sometimes I sleep with like a sock on because it's quite cold. And like, I never really thought about it because it was so logical. And then once, one of the other volunteers, she was like, why are you wearing only one sock? Like, when in the morning I come out of my room to the kitchen and I only have one sock on, and they're like, what's that about? And I realized that it's because usually when I sleep in like in a certain position. I don't know, you know, the one where you look like number four. I will put a picture of it here, I guess. And then it's always like one of my foot is like out of the blanket, but the other one is under the blanket. And usually the one that is under the blanket, that's where which sock I take off. And because I always, most always, sleep in the same position. And then I'm just like, why do I even bother putting on a sock? Because every morning it would be lost, and I would have to look for it. But now if I only put the sock on the foot that I actually need it on, so the foot that is out of the blanket, you know, like not under the blanket, it saves me time. I don't know why. I think it's genius, because it like balances off. Because one of your foot is under the blanket anyways, so it's warm. And the other one that is out of the blanket, it has a sock on, so it's warm too. Does it make sense? Okay, anybody? I hope somebody relates.
This one?
Oh my lord, it's like a cooking show. The lighting! Okay, yeah, as you can tell, the lighting is much better. And here I would like to thank today's sponsor. Not really, but shout out to Marianne, a fellow volunteer, who lent me this amazing ring light tripod thing. And yeah, what I'm doing now, I will be making the dough for the cinnamon rolls, because it needs to like set for like a few hours. And if you want to see the whole recipe, then go watch my last vlog with the birthday one. 25 grams of yeast, some milk. I'm using almond milk. I think any milk is fine. One egg of sugar, some flour. I don't know the measurements for the flour because you have to eyeball it, because my mom doesn't know the measurements. So therefore, I don't know the measurements. So therefore, we all have to eyeball it. Also, we need oil. So yeah. For the record, I have no idea how this is gonna turn out. So, let's get cooking. So all that I have to do now is leave it in the pot here and then cover it with a moist towel and then leave it in a warmer place. I'll put it on the radiator here because I will be turning on the heater anyway, so I could take a shower later. So it just works out perfectly for me. Okay, yeah, that's the tutorial for the cinnamon rolls, and I will see you after I have cleaned everything up. Oh, I forgot the last advent calendar to open. 24th. Wait, did I open? Yeah. 24th. Here. Ta-da! What is it? Let's take a guess. Maybe it's a Santa Claus? Oh. Can you tell what it is? Is it a hat? I don't know. We're done with this. I'm gonna wrap a present for myself. From myself. And let's put on a banger. Yes, it's Justin Bieber, mistletoe. We love it. Oh, also, here is a reminder for you to go get yourself a camera. I would recommend this one, where you can change the film inside, I guess. Because if you only get the disposable ones, it's a waste of plastic. So if you can get your hands on this one, I would recommend this one. You see? Amazing. I don't know. Because these pictures, they're so cool. Totally off topic, but whatever. Let's get to wrapping now. Okay. Margarita, I'm borrowing your glue stick, I'm sorry, but I don't have any. You can kind of see what was on the paper before, but we're not gonna let it distract us, it's okay. And it's kind of Christmassy, green. Me and like crafty things, we don't get along. We are not on good terms. Like, I can't even cut along the lines here. It's a pharmacy bag, so we're gonna have to roll with it. So on one side, I'm gonna write my name on here, but I have such an ugly handwriting. Yeah, I will do it like this. Or should I do it this way? Like from bottom to top or top to bottom? How? I think this one, yeah. Okay. Who let me do this? Where are my parents? That's all I'm asking. Like. Okay, let's turn another side and let's write Merry Christmas, but now I have to do it in the same font. I'll do it like we. Oh my lord, this is just going great for me. And now, okay, I will have to tape it. If you haven't done a Christmas present for yourself before, then this is your sign to do it next year. This is my second Christmas away from home, because last year, or like second Christmas in a row, and yeah, because last year I was in England during this time. I was working as an au pair, and then I didn't go home for Christmas because I was there only for a short amount of time, so it wouldn't have really like paid off to fly home again. And then yeah, I spent the Christmas there. Also, I don't know why I'm taping it shut like this, even though I will literally open it in like a few hours. Oh, it's whatever. It's almost 11 right now. Ta-da! This is my Christmas present. Should I tie a ribbon around here somehow? Like, I'll try. Oh, I will do it on both handles, both sides. Yes, yes, yes. Oh my lord, I'm so excited. And also the Christmas tree that we have here, I also made it. But I will show it to you later when I'm opening the... Oh! That looks so... Oh.
I will show you the Christmas tree later on. And this gift is sponsored also by my mother, who told me that she will sponsor this gift. Why does it actually look nice? I love it! Okay, so I will clean everything up here. Then I will get dressed and go for a walk. I mean, it's quite warm outside, I think. It's like 13 or 14 degrees, so it's good. This actually looks good. Okay, yeah, so I'm actually happy with the present. I will go put it under the tree.
And before I go, I have to turn on the heater, so when I come back, I can have a warm shower.
I will be taking my phone with me, but I won't be recording anything on the walk. I think, because it's literally me just walking, and I'm gonna listen to a podcast anyways. And I highly recommend listening to podcasts. Like, I like to only listen to podcasts when I'm walking for some reason, because then it feels like somebody else is talking with me, or like I'm having a conversation, but I don't have to say anything. So yeah, it's nice sometimes. Yeah, I am listening to it's an Estonian podcast called Täitsa Pekkis. So if you are an Estonian, then I highly recommend it. And if you're not, then maybe this is your time to start learning Estonian via podcasts. Okay, yeah. So I will see you when I'm back from my walk. I just got back from my walk. I think I'm gonna scream. I don't know what happened with my computer. If anybody knows, if my computer has been like, you know, somebody else is trying to get into my computer, then let me know, because I have no idea why it did a full reset, even though I didn't do anything. So yeah, I will just finish setting up my computer here, and then I will do a 20-30 minute yoga session, because it's so much needed. I need to calm my mind. Also, for some reason, 24th of December seems like it is supposed to be on a Thursday. Okay, anyways. I just finished with my yoga. It was yoga to feel your best yoga with Adrian, if anybody wants to do it too. Yeah, it's just a 20-minute yoga. Super easy, super quick. And now I will go take a shower.
Fresh out of the shower.
And around 3, it's 2:30 right now. Around 3, I will start preparing dinner, because it's going to take a bit of time. And I don't know if I mentioned it before, but for dinner I'm doing lentils meatloaf, because I don't eat meat. So I will have to like kind of improvise. So I will try to do this vegan meatloaf thing by a recipe that I found online. So fingers crossed that it's gonna work out okay. And then I will have some potatoes and like oven baked potatoes and carrots on the side. And also maybe some boiled beans, or like the green beans. Something like that. And then for breakfast, for dessert, I have cinnamon rolls, or I will be making the cinnamon rolls. Yes, we are back here, and I will start making the vegan lentil meatloaf thing. So my game plan is to put the lentils to boil right now. I will do the cinnamon rolls whilst the lentils are boiling, and then I will resume to the meatloaf. Okay, so we then need 1.5 cup of water with the vegetable broth. One of these things I will put into the water. 1 cup and 1/2 cup. So 1 cup of lentils. I'm gonna put this here to wait. Okay, yeah, so now we can get started with the cinnamon rolls. So basically I will make the cinnamon rolls ready, put them on the baking tray, and then after I have started to eat dinner, I will put them into the oven, because they're gonna need 25 minutes to get cooking. I am really, what's it called? In Estonia, it's germofo. Germofo, what is it? Like, you're scared of bacteria, that's me. And yeah. The water is boiling, so I will put the lentils in. Turn the heat down and let 35 to 40 minutes to, I think I have to put the lid on.
Okay, I hope it's good.
I almost tripped over this here. Love that for me, love that for me. So the lentils are boiling, or doing something. Okay, so now we need the dough, and the table is clean. Oh, we need flour. We have the flour. I think I'm gonna take the whole dough, because I think it's gonna be like one tray of samples, since I have the ingredients. We will roll it. Thank you.
shouldn't be seeing any dough. So I will take the lentils, they have been exactly 35 minutes. What was it? Don't know, okay. So I will chop everything up. We will chop this paprika into like fine. It says one small onion, but we love onions, so I think I'll put the whole thing in. Everything to the mixture, all of the spices and all, and I will link this recipe in the down bar, like the Estonian version, so if you want you can do that, Google Translate yourself. So I have the lentils here, and I have to like 3/4 of them after 30. I'm using this like 3/4. Now I'm waiting for the pan to heat up, and now I will puree these things. Wait, I need something else. I also need a lid for this. Okay, right now we have the warming them up. I mean, it's not really a puree, but it's for adds texture. Mixing, I need flour. I have to add this. Then I'll add the rest of the lentils. Then I'll add this. We'll add the vegetables here. 3/4 of oats. Oh, I love it. It doesn't look right here, but I have to add the mixture of the seeds that I had earlier here. Don't know what's gonna happen now. I will do it as a rectangle here, and then I will add potatoes and carrots on the side, put it in the oven for 40 minutes, and then I will go get ready. Yes. Oh, I'm a bit late. Okay, think fast. Okay, now I will peel a few potatoes, carrots, shove it in the oven, and get ready. I think I will do these three carrots. Anybody know how many potatoes a person eats? I mean, I can have it tomorrow too, so it's fine. Everything is okay, I have enough time. No need to hurry, no need to worry. Hi, I will quickly peel the potatoes and the carrots and put them in the oven, and I'm not gonna record it because it's pretty boring. I will see ya when everything is done and ready for the oven. That's how it looks like. Okay, I think it's fine, you know?
I will start doing my makeup now. Okay, so I will first start with my eyebrows, because if you know me, then eyebrows are the most important part of my face for me. And I'm like in front of the mirror right now. Like the mirror, I hate the word mirror. And I can see my reflection here. Okay, and I also wanted to kind of touch on the subject of being away from your family on Christmas, because I know that I'm not the only one. Okay, so yeah, being alone on Christmas. I feel like if you don't make it into a big deal, it's not a big deal. Like if you just accept, like, okay, yeah, this year I'm gonna have to be alone, and then you are, and it's fine. And also what helped me was that I made myself like a day plan, kind of, like a week ago. So I was like, I'm not gonna spend Christmas just sitting around, because I actually want to do something and spend time, if I can't, with my like family and friends and loved ones,
then I can spend it with myself because I'm a good company as well. But I mean, this year everything is different, and especially like this year, because of the pandemic we have, it is even more people are unable to see their families during Christmas. So that's why I also made the video, or that's why I'm also making this video, because I know that I'm not the only one, and it's just a reminder for everybody who couldn't spend Christmas with their family that they're not alone. And wow, I have to fix this. I can't really be bothered to do the brows because in the room, living room and everything, the lighting is so bad anyways. So you can't even see if I did anything wrong. I think I will just do like a full face of makeup because why not? If my brows are bad today, ooh, they're really bad. Wait, but if I'm far away, okay, let's keep a distance. So you can't really see my brows. Okay, now we're gonna do foundation. I'll just put some on. Oh, and also in the morning, as I said about my skin being bad, I have to wash it. Up until this year, up until my skin got bad here, I never washed my face like regularly. And now I do it every day, like in the morning and in the evening, because that's what you get if you don't appreciate your clear skin. It's gonna start attacking you. I wanna powder my face and then maybe put on some eyeshadow and blush and highlight. I don't have a bronzer, so I can't bronze my face, so I will just look like a ball with rosy cheeks. Don't see where I come from, my powder. It's broken, so it's in a Ziploc bag. Don't even say anything about it. So yeah, that's what's up with my Christmas. If you guys would like, you can let me know in the comments. How did you spend your Christmas? What do you eat on Christmas? You can leave it in the comments, or if you don't feel comfortable doing so, you can DM me on Instagram. Because why not? Because I want to know. And same goes with my blush. It's also broken in a Ziploc bag. I'm blushing. Yeah. And also on the nose. So they go on a bit cold. Oh no, it's a joke here. Did I put any eyeshadow on my eye or any powder on my eyes? Do eyeshadow quickly. I'm gonna hold you close. I also want to put some as a bronzer. Is it a bad idea? I feel like my friend who is a makeup artist, who I mentioned earlier in the day, the morning is gonna be like, bitch, what are you doing? And if you're watching this, I don't know what I'm doing. Oh my lord. Like, this is me. Like, the way that I do my makeup, this is literally me, like, who I am as a person. Okay, okay, so now I'm gonna put on highlight. Please, like, nobody come for my makeup routine. But I kinda like how I look right now. I think it's okay. I'll put on, like, shiny eyeshadow from here. This one. To give myself a bit of a more glow. Can you see it? Hope you can. I will do my lashes now. Okay, I can't talk and I do my lashes. And I think it's because of my sister. Because she always says, never talk when doing your lashes. And I kind of fucked up mine right now. Because I'm talking. Because I can't shut up.
Okay, for my lips. Oh, I'm sorry, the lighting is so bad. You're used to the ring light. But for my lips, I just put on Vaseline. Okay, wait, I will show you my makeup with the ring light. Then we can really tell if it's how bad it is. Are you ready for the reveal? Ta-da! Oh! No, but who is she? Who am I? Who is this pretty lady here? You can go and check on the meatloaf. And then I will check with my family how they are, what are they doing. And also, wait, the outfit is just, I don't know if you can see it. It's just
I'm a square. No, it's just these like black biker shorts and like a white sweater.
Okay, right now I'm having dinner with my family via Facebook Messenger, and this is the aftermath of my food. Let me explain. It's like fine, but I'm not the best chef. It's the most beautiful time of the year. Lights fill the streets, spreading so much cheer. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. I don't wanna miss out on the holiday, but I can't stop staring at your face. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. With you, shawty, with you. Everyone's gathering around the fire, chestnuts roasting like a hot July. I should be chilling with my folks, I know, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. Word on the street, Santa's coming at night. Reindeer's flying through the sky so high. I should be making a list, I know, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. Shorty, with you. Of this, the packaging is still amazing. What did I get for myself? First off, I got myself this chocolate Santa Claus. If you know me, then you know that I love chocolate, and if you don't, then hi, I love chocolate. I also like a spread as well. And then the main things that I got, first is this, if you remember from the morning that I have bad skin, this. I honestly have no idea about if it's good or not, but I just went to the pharmacy. I was like, hey, can you please help me? Because my skin is going through some rough times. So the woman, she suggested me this. I hope she understood what type of skin do I have. And then also this like Vichy face gel, a fresh cleansing gel. So yeah, that's what I got for myself for Christmas. I really like the present because I actually needed them, so I'm like totally fine. You know, in these terms and conditions, I think I had a great day, and I think it's gonna be fun to look back on it next year. So I'm very happy that I recorded it. Okay, I will talk to you when I'm doing something more interesting, or when I'm maybe just ending the vlog. So we'll see. The end of the day, I'm so tired, and I will take off my makeup now. So I just use this for to remove my makeup. You can let me know in the comments how was your day, and you can also let me know if you like the vlogs. Do you like the vlogs or not? Wash my face with this, and then I'll brush my teeth, and then I think before I go to bed I will edit a bit of the video because I'm really excited to edit it. And I mean, I know I'm gonna spend the whole day tomorrow doing it anyways, but I just want to get started a bit. I want to like kind of organize. And if you haven't yet, then please subscribe to my channel as well, the red subscribe thing, and if you like it, put on the notifications. So yeah, I hope that you liked the video. I hope that you had great Christmas, great holidays. If you don't celebrate anything, then I hope that you had a great day. And I guess I would just wish you Happy New Year as well, since it's coming up. Good night, people. Yeah, that's it. Okay, good night. See you in the next video. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye.